Good afternoon, everyone. It's such a pleasure to be here on this Monday, the 3rd of April, 2023. We're here to present our Music Day and to give God the praise and glory. So as his creatures, we are doing just that. And so to begin, we will have our opening song, which will be announced.
So we will begin the song, Soldiers of Christ Arise, number 616 in the Seventh-day Adventist hymnal.
Soldiers of Christ Arise, and put your trust is more than conqueror. Stand then in his great might, with all his strength endued, but take to arm you for the fight the panoply of God, that having all things done, conflicts past, you may overcome through Christ alone and stand entire at last. From strength to strength go on, wrestle and fight and pray, tread all the powers of darkness down, and still let the Spirit cry in all his soldiers, come till Christ the Lord, who reigns on high, shall take his conquerors
home. Our passage of meditation this afternoon is taken from Psalm 100. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. This is the word of the Lord. Amen.
Let us now invite God to be among us as we open our ceremony. Father in heaven, we want to thank you for your many blessings that you have bestowed upon us. Lord, we are your children, your daughters, your sons, and we ask that at this time that our feeble hearts be surrendered to you, asking you to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. As we sing praises to your name, O Lord, we ask that you accept your praises. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
On behalf of the Northern Caribbean University Music Department, I want to extend a sincere welcome to us this afternoon. We are indeed grateful for your presence, and that includes those persons who are online. The fact is that every semester we have been asked to do a Music Day event. And what I want to share with you this afternoon is that the mission theme, or the theme, the general theme for the university is embrace the mission and envision the future. And in doing so, we know that at this time of the year, we are conscious as the world celebrates the Easter time, and this is in commemoration of our Christ who died upon the cross. And so, with this in mind, is that I would like to actually share with you what it is that is so important to us as Adventist Christians. And this is coming from our prophet, Mrs. E.G. White. And what she mentioned here was that the kingdom of grace, which we now embrace, was instituted immediately after the fall of man. Yet it was not actually established until the death of Christ. Even after entering upon his earthly mission, the Savior might have drawn back from the sacrifice of Calvary. In Gethsemane, the cup of woe trembled in his hand. He might even have wiped the blood sweat from his brow, but have let the guilty race to perish in their iniquity. But when the Savior yielded up his life, and with his expiring breath cried out, "It is finished," then the fulfillment of the plan of redemption was assured. The promise of salvation made to the sinful pair in the Eden the Garden of Eden was ratified. The kingdom of grace, which had before existed by the promise of God, was then established. Hence, the death of Christ was that which have made it forever sure, which is centered in the future life and eternal happiness of all God's faithful ones in all ages. It is our hope that through this presentation today, that you will renew your commitment to Jesus, the Savior of the world. I now invite Ms. Glenda Anderson, faculty in the Department of Music and Fine Arts, to give us the introduction regarding the presenter today.
Dr. Anthony Gordon. Thank you. Dr. Anthony L. Gordon is a family relational specialist of international repute. And he has been asked to be our presenter today. Dr. Gordon has spent over 26 years up to 1997 as principal of three schools, including our own West Indies College Prep School. He has been a departmental director, regional president of JISA, and early childhood education board member. He also designed and conducted scores of staff development seminars and workshops for PTA groups, student and development behavioral modification seminars for those children who have behavioral and developmental problems. He has done this in Jamaica and in other countries overseas. Dr. Gordon has been able to be involved in work in the corporate world as well as internationally. And so he was a former member of the PSOJ, Manchester Chamber of Commerce, presenter at the Kiwanis and Rotary Clubs, among other business associations. He has traveled widely across the Caribbean, inclusive of Cayman Islands, the Bahamas, the Dominican Republic, and he has visited other countries, USA, Canada, Mexico, Netherlands, and Africa. But presently, as the family relational specialist, he has engaged much in family life education, providing counseling, research, and he has done writing, specializing in marriage, parenting, and human sexuality. He has many books, CDs, DVDs, relating to counseling and family life ministries. He's also an author and has a few books out, and he writes in The Gleaner and The Observer. He has worked preparing workshops for Jamaica National Building Society, from which he has produced 5 DVDs, and he has also worked with the Victoria Mutual Building Society, providing the same service. And in our church, he has worked as the past director of Family Life Ministries and Family Counseling Services, providing all these to our church members. He has also been an associate chaplain of the Jamaica Constabulary Force. From what I have read, and there's much more, Dr. Gordon is eminently qualified to speak to us today, and because he loves music, and also based on his latest published work, which is Family Relational Health, Songs of Praise and Bible Verses. This book was launched last week, March 29, 2023. So as he shares with us today, please listen and be blessed.
The songs that the choir will now perform are as follows. I Am, composed by David Clydesdale, and also Look at the World, and the composer is John Rutter, and our conductor is Mr. Nicholas Brumfield. Thank you.
Thank you. Dr. Anderson, Dr. Peterkin, and all the rest of us from the music department here at NCU, friends, ladies and gentlemen, just want to say that Sister Glenda left the, shall I say, the best part of the introduction for me to do, and I didn't mind that. That is to say, with me today is the wind into my wings, not beneath, into my wings. That is to say, she who helps to propel me along for these 47 years, my wife Dolores. We're happy to be here, back at home. And I just want to express my appreciation, Dr. Anderson and your team, for giving me the opportunity to identify and connect with you here. And in the brief remarks I have to make, I'd like to anchor my comments in Ephesians chapter 6, verse 12, which says, "For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places." You might have heard that one of my works is this book, Songs of Praise and Bible Verses Paraphrase. One of the things I give God thanks for is the opportunity is to paraphrase in the context of the issue being discussed. And so when I thought about coming here this morning, Doc, I prayed and I asked the Lord to help me to do a meaningful paraphrase of the text I just read in the context of the event. So here's the latest of my paraphrase. "For we wrestle not against ordinary temptations to sway from God's ideal for our music ministry, but we play and sing against the subliminal, cacophonous messages of the dynamic international music industry. We play and sing against the subtle and overt messages of the satanic forces hell-bent at commandeering and capturing our God-given talents and abilities. We play and sing against the powers of popularism and societal showmanship manifested steadily in the ever-increasing genres, styles, classification, and brands. Indeed, members of the music department, we play and sing against the heaving powers of darkness from the exalted musical intelligentsia of Satan's kingdom, parading as talents of light, but all heading to the pit of hell." Ladies and gentlemen, I suggest to you what I sought to capture there is a harsh reality as it relates to what is happening in the music world. I'd like to suggest to you, therefore, what I call a poignant statement. That is to say, maybe the most powerful, most influential art form in human existence is the combination of music and singing. If we take a biblical historical look at what I just said, it takes us back to Ezekiel 28 and Isaiah 14, where we're told that sin mysteriously, and I know you in music, you've heard this repetitiously, that sin mysteriously began where again? In the music department, in heaven, by the chief musician of the angelic choir. Today, in the music industry, has over 44 genres that are influencing lives from the ghetto to the palace. The power of music. Your theme is enhance the mission and vision the future. I'd like to suggest to you that one of the first evidences of this was the case of the children of Israel on their mission from Egypt to Canaan. We're told that music and singing was part of which kept their spirit buoyant through the treacherous sojourn from Egypt to Canaan. Music and singing. As I put my thoughts together, may I tell you this, that I remember in the mid-70s, when I studied music appreciation right there and where the library is now, that's where the music building was, right, sister? Anybody remembers that? I remember studying from the seven periods of music, early music, the Renaissance, the classical, the Baroque, the Romantic, the 20th century, and the modern. And you know, one thing that caught me then was the suggestion that the days will come when the regular forms and patterns, as demonstrated here so ably in these classical types, will change so dramatically that you won't even be able to follow. And I wondered, how could that ever be true? Well, God has spared my life to live long enough to see that. But you know, one of the challenges I want to say to those of us who are in music, is that we need to make our music, our songs, current, relevant, speaking to the issues of the day. That's what arrested my attention when I set out to compose these 52, you heard me right, 52 songs I composed there with reference to issues affecting the family. And I'm going to invite you now, I'm going to convert you all into a choir. How about that? So I'm going to invite you to share with me, yes, and I see you're going to get some music, number 18, and you have the copies there, and I think it might be on the screen. It is, good. So I composed this song to the tune of Blessed Assurance. It is Home Health Assurance. So I'm going to expect you all to sing as though you knew it before, and you're going to sing under my baton. How about that? Let's go. Singing, Home Health Assurance, coverage for all, healthcare provider, Jesus our Lord, against all COVID, families stand tall, our homes united, in one accord. Chorus now, sing. We have one story, we have one song. Whether there's COVID, we're strong in the Lord. We have one story, we have one song. What is it? Help the assurance, coverage. Second stanza singing, Home Health Assurance, body and mind, benefits all in, premiums full pay, all forms completed, signed in his blood. Spirit is agent, no grants need pain. We have one story, we have one song. Whether there's COVID, we're strong in the Lord. We have singing church, oh Melchizedek, coverage. And now the last stanza, singing, oh Melchizedek, coverage for all against pandemics, against all sin. God is God's policy, destined to win. Hearts bond together, pouring His word. We have one story, we have one song. Whether there's I'm gonna interrupt you now, because you know those of us from the crusade time and the outlet, you know, when we sing this, we don't just sing we have one story, we really sing it in the might and power. So we're gonna sing this now. Sing with me. We have one story, we have one song. What is it? Oh, Melchizedek, coverage for. Amen. Point I want to make is that as I travel the world and I meet my various clients and see the impact that COVID-19 has been having, wreaking havoc in homes, I couldn't help but seek the Lord to help me to compose songs in that context. That is one. I've already pointed out to you that the children of Israel survived by, you know, singing and making melody in their heart. Let's bring that fast forward. We, the modern children of Israel, according to Galatians 3:27-29, we're passing through the present wilderness of sin on our way to the spiritual Canaan when Christ returns. We too will be kept by the positive impact of quality songs and lyrics which speak directly to the challenges that we meet. It is understood that as we that we'll encounter many of these challenges in the sensitive behind closed door issues of family life in our homes. Hence, we need to sing more of them at our evening and morning worships. We need to sing songs that will uplift the spirit of each family member and stabilize and anchor our relationships. So let me wind this 20 minutes down and bring it home to your mission and vision. Again, I'll go back to the Great Commission, that we're to go ye and teach all nations, baptizing them, and you know the rest of it there, baptizing in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I've commanded you, and lo, I'm with you always, even unto the end of the world. I'd like to suggest, in the context of the vision, in strategic planning that I taught for many years, I was a strategic developer for Central Conference while I was there, there's what we call the preferred future. I suggest to you, those of us who are in music, let the preferred future of our ministry circles around Ephesians 4:13. That is to say, let us sing songs of praise and glory unto God till we all come in the unity of the faith and in the knowledge of the Son of God unto a perfect man under the measure of the stature of the fullness of Christ. And so, I'd like to close my brief remarks by inviting you to sing yet another song that speaks now a little more directly to some of the present day challenges and issues in family, and therefore music need to be created to bring this out. I composed this one, it's number 48 in my book. I composed it to the tune of Watchmen on the Walls of Zion. And the title of the song, as you might have in your on your paper there, and it should be on the screen, yes, is Watchful Family Leaders. Singing, family leaders in the Lord, can't you see the telltale signs? Husbands, fathers, wives and mothers, don't you read between the lines? Brothers, sisters, look, behold the gates of hell now parade against God's structured family cleansing. Sound the warning, keep not silent, family life's under attack. Let us rally and with one voice come together and fight back. Christ says, be of good cheer, ye shall overcome. And good lives we live through Christ to strengthen them. Let us stabilize and anchor our faith in God's own plan. Raise the bar and lift the standard, share the truth that we began. No evolution but Bible creation. No modification but God's redemption. Now the last stanza, come on, sing. All God's children, we are vanguards of the family I. Live and tell and share the message. Know what prophecy reveals. Gates of hell will rise, but they cannot prevail. Christ is coming, faithful families to save. For we wrestle not against ordinary temptations to sway from God's ideal of our music ministry, but we play and sing against the subliminal cacophonous messages of the dynamic international music industry. We play and sing against the subtle and overt messages of the satanic forces hell-bent at commandeering and capturing our God-given talents and abilities. We play and sing against the powers of popularism and societal showmanship manifested steadily in the ever-increasing genres, styles, classifications, and brands. Indeed, ladies and gentlemen, we play and sing against the heaving powers of darkness from the exalted musical intelligentsia of satanic kingdom, parading as talents of light. But we know all are headed to the pit of hell. I challenge you, while I encourage you in the music field, be faithful, sing always as unto the Lord, and He will crown your effort with success. Thank you.
Thank you. His heart was broken, mine was mended. He became sin, now I am clean. The cross he carried bore my burden. The nails that held him set me free. His life for mine, his life for mine. How could it ever be that he would die? God's son would die to save a wretch like me. What love divine, he gave his life for mine. His scars of suffering brought me healing. He spilled his blood to fill my soul. His crown of thorns made me royalty. His sorrows gave me joy untold. His life for mine, his life for mine. How could it ever be that he would die? God's son would die to save a wretch like me. What love divine, he gave his life for mine. He was despised and rejected, stripped of his garment and oppressed. I am loved and accepted, and I wear a robe of righteousness. His life for mine, his life for mine. How could it ever be that he would die? God's son would die to save a wretch like me, like me. What love divine, he gave his life for mine, for mine.
Mic check. Good afternoon. I don't know about tomorrow. I just live from day to day. I don't borrow from its sunshine, for its skies may turn to gray. I don't worry o'er the future, for I know what Jesus says. And today he walks beside me, for he knows what is ahead. Many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand, but I know who holds tomorrow, and I know who holds my hand. Every step is getting brighter as the golden stairs I climb. Every burden's getting lighter, every cloud is silver lined. There the sun is always shining, there will be no setting sun. At the ending of the rainbow, where the mountains touch the skies, many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand. And I know who holds my hand. I don't know about tomorrow. I just live from day to day. I don't borrow from its sunshine, for its skies may turn to gray. I don't worry o'er the future, for I know what Jesus says. And today he walks beside me, for he knows what is ahead. Many things about tomorrow I don't seem to understand, but I know who holds tomorrow, and I know holds my hands.
was life filled with aimless desperation. Without hope walked the shell of a man. Then a hand with a nail print stretched downwards. Just one touch, then a new life began. And the old rugged cross, it made the difference in a life that's bound for heartaches and defeat. I will praise Him forever and ever for the cross made the difference for me. There are many individuals I know who did not believe in the cross of Calvary. And you see, because of this, they're resting in Christ's graves. Then I know of others who did believe in the cross. They're resting and they're waiting the coming of Jesus. So, no matter what you're going through today, just keep believing in the cross. Because you see, for me, it's the only hope we have. See, there's room. It's filled with sad, ashen faces. Without hope, death has wrapped them in a gloom. Oh, at the side of saints there's rejoicing. In a tomb, and the old rugged cross made the difference. You see, in a life that's bound for heartaches and defeat, I will praise Him forever and ever, for the cross made the difference for me. Yes, the cross made the difference for me.
This weekend has been one when we saw the Department of Music and Fine Arts on tour. And the department started out at the Mandeville Seventh-day Adventist Church on Sabbath, with its Easter musical praise under the theme, Jesus, the Savior of the World. And what an afternoon morphed into an evening of blessing that rained down from the department through the various performances of our guests. We had a wonderful time. Then yesterday we had the Community Music School recital right here on campus. And what an afternoon it was. From 3:30 for the next 2 hours, we had young people, middle age, and those in my category. And I did make them a promise some time ago, was it last year? That this Community Music School recital would not miss me. But it did. And I do have a mouth organ at home. I have a saxophone at home. I have a piano at home. And I have the cheer of the Department of Music and Fine Arts as my teacher. So, come the next Community Music Day, if I'm not playing, and I'm not giving you the year, but if I'm not playing, I'll be on stage. But I've got to be doing something before something happens to me. Today, Monday Chapel from the Department of Music and Fine Art has been very refreshing and rewarding. And we want to thank everyone for your performances and our guest presenter for his presentation along with his two minted songs. We're very happy for you and your dear wife of many years. 47. Amazing. 47. I knew you guys when you were dating. So, we have come to the end of another tour of duty. And we hope that you have been tremendously blessed. Summer camp for the Department of Music, the Community Music School. Registration begins on April 11th, and summer camp begins on May 10th. So we're asking everyone who wants to know how to play something, come over to the Department of Music and Fine Arts. And if you have children that you want to have them occupied for the summer, bring them over to the Department of Music summer camp. It is going to be a wonderful experience. And I might just pass through. If you join me in standing, we will have the closing prayer. Let's pray. God of heaven, we just want to thank you for gifting us with good singing, music of the right type. We thank you for the Department of Music and Fine Arts, Dr. Anderson and the team of teachers and students and all those who work and minister in that department. What a great department it is, championing your cause through music. We thank you for this afternoon's presentations, and we pray that you're going to bless everyone, to include all those of us who listened and were blessed. We seek now your peace as we separate one from the other, that you will continue to grant us your mercies and help, O God, that each of us we'll be able to play the right music in our hearts, in our lives, in our every experience, that heaven will be pleased and our reward will be guaranteed a place in your eternal kingdom. Give us a great rest of the afternoon and watch over us now, we pray, in Jesus' name. Amen. Blessings on all. Have a great afternoon.